Hello everyone, this is Harsh and you are watching WPF World. In this video, we are going to learn how to create the setup using WiX. Without wasting the time, let's get started. To create WiX project, we have to use WiX extension. Here I am using Visual Studio 2019. So I will download Visual Studio 2019 extension. Go to this link and click on download. You can choose the folder where you want to download the setup. Now setup is downloaded. Let's run the setup. Before that, we have to close the Visual Studio if any Visual Studio instance is running. Now let it install. To get more update on WPF, subscribe this channel. Now installation is done. Now we can open the Visual Studio. Now here we can create new project for the WiX. So click on add and click new project. Type WiX and search for WiX project. Here you can find setup project for WiX V3. So let's select it and click on next. Type the project name. I will enter WPF world. Click on create. Now I would like to review what gets generated. We have our product element. The 5 required window installer property are defined as XML attribute, which are ID, name, language, version and manufacturer. The ID maps to the product code. You can see that it's set to an star. This means that WiX will generate a new GUID for each build. The name attribute specifies the name of the product. This name will be displayed in the programs and feature, and if the package has UI, it will be used in various places there. Next is the language attribute, which is set to 1033. This is the local ID for English, United States. The version is the product version, and this is also viewable from the program and features. The manufacturer is simply a string where you can put your organization's name. Next, we have media template element. This element takes care of automatically assigning file to cap file, saving you from having to manage this. One thing useful here is the embed cap attribute, which we can see later. Setting this to true instructs the WiX binder to embed the cap files inside the MSI file, making for more self-contained install package. Here we have the directory where our application is going to install. So here you can see directory ID target dir and source dir, and directory ID program files folder, means our application will install in program files folder. Make sure you enter right ID here. So here I have set the name as WPF world. So when we install the application, our application name will be WPF world. This is the place where we can add the resources, like if you want to insert the file, restrict your other resource, we can add it here. So here we will add component tag. In the component tag, we will specify our project, for which project we are going to make the setup. So here we have to use file tag, and here we'll enter source as WPF tutorial series dot target path, so that it will take our application. So now add the references for the project which we want to create the setup. Go to references and click on add references. Here you can select project and click on add, and then click on OK. Now our project is added to our WiX project. Here I will enter manufacturer as WPF world. Now let's first build our WPF application, then build WiX project. So here you can see the error. The WiX toolset v3.11 build tools must be installed to be built the project. So let's install the WiX toolset. Go to this URL and install the WiX toolset. Here download WiX 3.11.exe. Select the folder where you want to download. Now download is done. Let's run this exe. Let it install. Now installation is completed. Now let's build our WiX project. Again we can see the error. So let's restart our Visual Studio and now try to build our WiX project. Now build is succeeded. Now go to the folder where our WiX project is present. Here inside the bin folder we have debug folder. Inside the debug folder we have our setup. You can see here we have .cap file, .msi file, WiX PDB files. We can install our application using .msi file. So double click on MSI. It will start installing our application. As I told, this will install in program files. You can see inside the program files, we have WPF world folder. Inside that we have WPF tutorial series.exe. Now let's run our exe. You can see our application is running now. Now we can use our application. You can see here we have cap file. I don't want to create cap file. So for that, what we should do? We should go inside the product WXX file, and inside the media template element, we have to use embed cap equal to yes. Then it will not create a separate cap file. Okay, now let's try to build our WiX project. And let's see inside the debug folder. You can see now cap file is not there, right? Now I want to add shortcut to the start menu. For that, I will add one component rep with ID application shortcut inside the feature element. Now inside the directory, I will add one more directory for the start shortcut. Now I will add directory ref for this application program folder. Inside the directory ref, we will add one component application shortcut, and here we will specify the target and the working directory for our application for which we want to create the shortcut. So inside the shortcut element, we will add the ID application start menu shortcut, and then I will add the name WPF word, and the target will specify as product component, and then I will specify working directory as our application directory where our application is installed. Here we are getting one error: the target attribute is not allowed. Let's see what is the error. Okay, here I have used file. We have to use shortcut element here, not the file element. Now let's replace file with shortcut and then specify the target. Now for the component element, we have to add GUID. I will create one GUID and specify that GUID inside this component element. Now let's build our WiX project. Here we are getting one error. To resolve this error, we have to specify key path in the component element with ID application shortcut. So let's specify key path to yes. Now let's build our WiX project. Now our WiX project is succeeded. Okay, here I did one mistake. So here we will have to add the directory with program menu folder ID. Make sure it should be similar to program menu folder, because it is the predefined ID for the start menu. Now let's build our project. Now we are getting multiple error. To fix this error, we have to add the remove file element and registry element. Now let's see how to add that. So inside the component, after the shortcut element, we will add the remove folder element. Here we will specify the directory application program folder. Let's specify ID as cleanup shortcut. And specify the on attribute as uninstall. This means that our shortcut will also remove on uninstallation of our application. So now we have to specify the registry key, like where this application will be installed in registry. To add the registry key, we have to use registry value element. Here we will specify the root HKCU and the key software / WPF world. Means inside HKCU software / WPF world, our application will be installed. Type will be integer and value will be 1, and we will say name WPF world. Okay. Now let's build. Okay, here we are getting one error. The component element has multiple key path set. So I will remove one key path from this. I will remove this key path. Now let's build and see. Our build is succeeded. Now let's see our application setup. Now install this MSI and see if we got our application in start menu or not. Type WP World, we got WP World, right? Now we can click to this and we can use our application. See, we have WP World. In the similar way, we can add the shortcut to the desktop. So again, we have to add one more directory element with ID desktop folder. And also we have to add the directory rep. Here we will use shortcut element and I will remove this remove folder element. And I will add one component rep with ID desktop folder shortcut, which we have specified as a ID for the component element. Now let's build our application. Here build got failed. Let's see what is the error. You can see here error, ID desktop folder shortcut has a GUID value, this one, that duplicate another component. Let's replace this GUID with new GUID. I will create new GUID and I will replace this GUID with new GUID. Now let's build again. Now build is succeeded. Now let's go to the debug folder and try to install this MSI. Once installation is done, we can see the shortcut to the desktop. You can see here WP World. But here we want to change image for this shortcut. Now let's see how to change the image for this application. So here we have wpfworld.ico file. Go to property of this file and change the build action as resource and copy to output directory to copy always. Now go to the project property and select this file or the icon. Now let's build and see. Now let's install this MSI and see. Now you can see we have a shortcut with the image. I hope you learn how to create the setup using Wix, and also you have learned how to create the shortcut for our application, like for start menu and for desktop, and also you have learned how to change the icon of shortcut, and also you have learned how to change the desktop icon shortcut. If you feel this video is helpful for you, then let's share with your friends.